Not too long ago, Samsung just launched a brand new Samsung Galaxy A50s in the Malaysian market, and it comes at a price of 1,299 ringgit. And today, in this video, we're going to take a look around this whole phone and see how it performs with other competitors. This video is brought to you by SecureDrive BT. SecureDrive BT is a super speedy external SSD storage drive with AES 256-bit XTS hardware encryption. The SecureDrive BT communicates with the easy-to-use companion app that is available on both iOS and Android to unlock its access. The drive can be unlocked via Touch ID, Face ID, or other similar biometrics on Android smartphones. You can also enable two-factor authentication through your phone number and remotely wipe the drive via the app itself. The SecureDrive BT works with any operating systems while offering a peace of mind for the security and privacy of your files. Click the link in the description below to learn more, as it is also available in other form factors. Firstly, let's start off with the design of it. So the Galaxy A50s is actually having the same design as the Galaxy A30s. It comes with this tiled diamond facade design. And I particularly like the A50s because it also comes with this prism crush green color, which is very similar to the Galaxy S10 Plus's prism green color, which is actually my favorite. As for the display of the Galaxy A50s, it comes with a 6.4-inch 1080p display with this infinity V notch at the top there. And overall, this Super AMOLED display is really bright and vivid, like any other Samsung displays out there. And yeah, it's just really typical of Samsung AMOLED displays. The Samsung Galaxy A50s also comes with triple card slots, so you get two dedicated nano SIM card slots and a micro SD card slot, all separate from each other. Of course, you also get an audio jack with a USB Type-C port alongside with your speaker at the bottom here. So yeah, it is really typical in phones of this price range nowadays. As for the cameras in the Samsung Galaxy A50s, you get a depth sensor at the top, a 48MP f2.0 camera at the center, and then another 8MP ultra-wide angle camera at the bottom. So in terms of picture quality, the main 48MP camera sensor here is actually pretty good. It produces really nice colors, nice saturation, nice color balance and everything else. And when you switch to the ultra wide angle camera, things start to get a little bit funky. So for some reason, the saturation is cranked all the way up, the contrast is also increased, making it a lot more dramatized, as you will. And overall, the picture looks very punchy and gets attention on social media, but it definitely is not close to what you see with your own eyes. And also, Samsung, please reduce your watermark size because it's just way too big at the bottom there. As for the software side of things, the Samsung Galaxy A50s comes with One UI version 1.5. And you also get most of the Samsung features right here. So for example, you also get Edge panel, but the Edge panel here is not complete. So for example, I always use the Smart Select on my Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus, but the Edge panel here is not complete and it does not have Smart Select, which is one of the features that I always use. However, you do get Link to Windows, which is the brand new feature that was launched with the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 series, and you also get Samsung Pay, which is my personal favorite Samsung feature. As for the specs of the Galaxy A50s, it comes with a Samsung Exynos 9611 chipset, 4GB of RAM and 64GB of internal storage. And overall, the performance is quite comparable with the Snapdragon 660, it's slightly below it. So the CPU performance is okay, but the GPU performance is not really up to par with the Snapdragon 660. So when it comes to games alone, I kind of found the differences there, because when you play some games like PUBG Mobile, for example, you can go to the lower settings with ultra frame rates, but when you start to crank up your graphical settings, it starts to stutter a bit. Same goes to Honkai Impact 3 when I played it in the highest graphical settings. It's quite stuttery. However, COD Mobile actually runs fine on this phone with the maximum graphical settings. The battery inside the Galaxy A50s is a 4000 mAh battery. It can last for about 13 hours in our battery life test. It's kind of common nowadays, and it can last you throughout the day without any issues, although you cannot really play games much on it. As for the charger, it comes with Samsung's 15W fast charging, and it can charge to about 50% in 36 minutes and 75% battery in 64 minutes. And surprisingly, we tested it with our usual 10-watt charger and the speed isn't really that much difference, but there is a margin that is significantly faster on the 15-watt charger. So overall, the Galaxy A50s for the price of 1,299 ringgit, I find it to be a tad bit expensive as usual with any Samsung mid-range smartphones, but you do get an entry point into Samsung's ecosystem, particularly Samsung Pay and some other really useful features like Edge Panel, even though it's only partially in the Samsung Galaxy A50s. So the price of 1,299 is actually the value that it gives instead of the specs that it gives. So if you still want to compare it with any other mid-range smartphones around this price range, well, you pay the price of a bit of performance for the ecosystem and ease of use in terms of software. So is the Galaxy A50s recommended? I would suggest you to take a look at the Samsung ecosystem, and if you really want to try that ecosystem, which I highly recommend you to do so, then yes, you can take a look at the Galaxy A50s and make a purchase. So that is all I have to say about the Samsung Galaxy A50s. I hope you like this video, and we will see you in the next video.